UniFi Protect 4 is here, and there are a ton of improvements and features to talk about. We got a lot to cover, so let's get started. UniFi Protect 4 was switched to GA this morning, and it comes with some significant improvements. As of the recording of this video, my UNVR has been updated to UniFi OS 4.0.3 with Protect version 4.0.21. Now, if you click on the notes icon just to the right of those version numbers, you can see all of the release notes. I'm not going to cover every single new feature here, but I have handpicked some of my favorites, and you can check out the release notes for everything else that has changed. Topping those release notes are Protect performance improvements. Ubiquiti states that they now have a re-architected NVR core engine that brings a faster user experience and increases camera capacity by 20%. Faster user performance means that when you're viewing Protect camera footage in your browser or with the Protect app on your smartphone, it should be significantly faster. Protect has always suffered from occasional stutters in playback, I mean, especially if you're on a slower connection, so hopefully now that is much improved. When they say that they've increased camera capacity, that probably has to do with the way that the footage is stored on the hard drive. I assume it's something to do with optimizing pixels that don't change from frame to frame, but that's just speculation on my part. They're telling you that there's 20% additional storage capacity. In addition to that, you can now choose to store footage on the NVR downscaled to 2K or HD quality. So for example, if you got a camera that's, you know, just watching a hallway or a doorway, and you don't really need full 4K quality on the playback, like if HD is good enough, you now have the option to save footage in HD in order to save hard drive space. A new feature that I really love is the video archiving. There's now a video archiving widget on the left-hand side of the screen that allows you to connect your Google Drive or Microsoft OneDrive account to UniFi Protect. Once you've connected that account, you can then click export and choose the date range, which cameras you want to export, and then the destination for your footage. Once you tell it to export, it works in the background to upload all of your selected footage to your destination. Now I connected to Google Drive and it created a UniFi folder in my Google Drive account with the exported footage organized into subfolders by date. Another new improvement is camera shortcuts, which I actually think is a really cool idea. So basically you can add shortcuts to different cameras on the playback window of any other camera. All right, so let's take a look at this example. Here I am in Protect and I'm gonna click on the playback here. And then I'm gonna choose one of my cameras. So for instance, I have shortcuts set up on my front driveway camera. You can see this is the shortcut right here. To add more shortcuts, like if I wanted to add one to my front door doorbell camera, I can say edit shortcuts, and then click over here to add a new one and then pick my doorbell. So now I've got my doorbell shortcut going this way and my side yard shortcut going that way. All right, so here you see my front yard camera and I have a shortcut here that goes to my side yard. So if I hit play on this footage, you'll see me walk in from the right-hand side of the frame. And once I get off frame, I can click that shortcut and it goes to the other camera. So now I'm in my side yard, same exact time frame, and then when I go off screen here, I can click the next shortcut, and that goes over to my greenhouse camera. So now you can see that I'm now walking into the greenhouse, and I'm gonna check on my plants or whatever. You also see my brand new puppy pop into the screen here. Ah, there he is. So that's a super cool feature, and it's really useful for tracking people across multiple cameras. It just makes it super easy to do that. Another cool idea is area of interest filtering. So now you can filter for events that took place within a specific area of a camera's field of view. So for example, say you have a camera in your backyard and off to the left-hand side of that camera is a gate that leads out of your property. Well, you can now filter down or search on movement or events that happened in just that area of the playback window, as in, you know, just show me movement related to the area of the screen that contains this gate. All right, that's pretty sweet. Similarly, they've added vehicle of interest. license plates show up in the recognition page, and now you can add labels and descriptions for individual license plates. You can also set event notifications when that particular license plate is detected, like send me a notification when my wife gets home. Another long anticipated feature is PTZ patrol mode. So for the G4 PTZ cameras and any future PTZ cameras that UI may or may not come out with, you can set a start and end point for those cameras to pan between. Now this is great for keeping a better eye on like large open spaces. And finally, the last feature that I'll mention here is that you can now add custom animations to the screen of the Doorbell Pro. You can use JPEGs, PNGs, or GIFs that are larger than 240 by 240 pixels in size. So yeah, many, many new improvements. I was able to upgrade my own UNVR without issue, so go ahead and give UniFi Protect 4 a shot. All right, that's it for now, but if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my wireless design for the silver mining ghost town of Cerro Gordo, California, and the bottom video is my overview of the new 16-port UniFi Pro Max switch with Ether lighting.